So, where should we start?
My prism's a cat A, pillars holding my cell, soon to fall like they did with Silas and Paul. I'm sure death is my fate. To end this sentence, I've been serving in the church, but there's sin lurking. I've been swerving on the verge of insanity. Oh, so gradually, apathy mixed with agony at the internal anarchy. I'm a sinner, a singer who had the riffs and the rhythms, the congregation's ovations because of the gifts I've been given. Nobody would ever question me. Lack of confrontation of detriment to my destiny. Desperately, they attest to the euphony as the proof of me truthfully being suited for ministry. If it's musically pleasing, appealing to people, preying and praising, placing their gaze on my gifting, lifting my feet onto stages, staging parades that are glistening. It's a farce, a facade that conceals the dark in my heart. To be real is far from the mark, as revealed by carnal remarks. I bought books on theology, thinking that they would do the job. Now my mind's consumed up in a room of fog. I could recount my splurging and spurging. I'm now in search of a surgeon to pounce and purge all the scourge that I fought to swerve my discernment, to turn from circuits of scripture and burn a perfect picture, to earn the murkiest mixture of earthly curses, afflictions, addictions, diction, profanity filled. And what calamity killed? Vanity's thrill got me dancing. This is insanity still. High intensity exercise and my mind serves to emphasize the decline as I swirl and swallow the slime that's from agony's pill. I self-medicate with self-pity to manage my ills.
My life's a mess, man.
And though I feel a bit calmer through this catharsis inside, I feel like I die like the saints and pastors at Sardis. Like, can I handle the truth? I'm the brand of a builder's boot, and I crawled and trod under tree trunk so I can yam on the fruit. Been infected like I've laid with a lady laden with syphilis, soon to be slain with shame, and now nature's arranged my chrysalis. Cocoon's the cold word for the coffin that I'll be fitted in,
but unfit for positions that I was given.
Now my identity's dented, cause it essentially centered around my gifting. I'm drifting and I'll eventually venture into the morgue for my morphine. I'm morning to evening, body horizontal position, my forehead forced at the ceiling. Sealing my fate, fake faith, the fatal feature. My faulty foundations deepen the hole as I'm faint and weak, and my soul cannot take the grief and the groans. The decay is eating my bones. I pray for freedom to roam from this place that keeps me alone in a cage of feelings. I moan, medicate my grievings, console, setting straight beliefs which I've owned that relate to keeping a code of expected behavior. Savior, the taste and flavor of fame, prostitute your gifting whilst risking what's best to make you a name. Yeah, I did it, and it's resulted in death. This elegy sucks my energy, I'm consulting my flesh. I operated in purpose, no preparation, and service without salvation. I'm nervous because damnation is surely what's next. Jesus, I served in your name solely for the purpose of fame. Free me from the circus of shame, I plead with you now. You wore a coat of flesh, thrived and lived in it perfectly. Died with rivers of burgundy so I could lay my burdens right by the river like Bermondsey. My heart is cold when someone revived the rhythm with urgency, and now I've got these vivid and violent visions of purgatory. Even though it's not biblical,
but I'm ending my journey. My only hope is that you would extend the measure of mercy.
I'm coughing, I'm in my coffin, cacophony of the scuffing is stopping me as I'm plotting my plan of escape. I now enter into a realm called death with both hands on the handles of faith. My story is finished. Just as I think I'm on the brink to disintegrate and be over, I blink and wake from my coma with scintillating scotoma. I sniff amazing aromas, my wings are blazing. Jehovah has infiltrated and traded my place in death. No longer an elegy, but a rebirth is the name that I'm calling this. Melancholy and mourning was offered a metamorphosis. Morphed into something more, I'm in awe. I feel the endorphins, the door unlocked. I'm implored to preach more to people and talk of this.